Yes, everybody, welcome, welcome, welcome. Here's again, I got a podcast show ready to line up and ready to go, ready to go. We are going to talk about, this guy needs no introduction since he's passed away. He goes by the name of George Floyd. People who don't know George Floyd will look him up on the web browsers. George Floyd, they're having a funeral service for George Floyd. As of now, he's still in the casket. When we all pass away, when we all people around the world pass away, it doesn't matter who you are, a child, a children, adult, a young kid to an older adult, we're all going to meet our Maker in the heavens. We're all going to see Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, did mention about children of the world today. They really mentioned about children of today in the Bible, in the Bible, the Holy Bible book. They mentioned children in some paragraph. I forget what it's called. If someone can remind me about that, can put it out there, that's great. But yeah, I'm not here to talk about children. I'm here to talk about George Floyd. That's the person we need to talk about, George Floyd. Now, I haven't talked about him ever since he passed away. That police officer, well, I'm not going to mention his name, the guy holding him down. He couldn't breathe. He could hear it on the mobile devices that people had there. They got up there, their iPhones filmed it. Another TV camera did do that. But these people who have, you know, so-called iPhones, mobile device things, what you call them, or, camera phones. I guess they call them camera phones. Anyway, they filmed it, make it look like a selfie or video in terms of vlogging. They vlogged out and told the police officer to get his foot off the guy's neck. This was George Floyd, and the police officer, I don't know what the police officer's name, but this happened like I think a week ago, and it just stems all the way back from a week ago. And George Floyd, he's the same age as me, born in 73, died a week ago. Bad circumstances, under bad circumstances. The police officers that were in the video apparently got arrested. Now they had second degree murder. Now second degree murder, if you don't know already, is a very bad idea. You don't want to do anything to harm anybody. Now that's what they do mean. They don't want to harm people, harm the public out there. That's what the police officer did. He put his foot on the George Floyd's neck. Right to the ground. This is information I'm getting through YouTube videos, to the videos I saw, to I'm hearing on a TV show. Today is the funeral service of George Floyd. You can hear in the background, that's George Floyd's funeral service going on at this very moment at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. That's 2 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. That's right, folks. 2 o'clock in the afternoon, Canadian time. And, he's not going to die in vain. With the people who've done that to him are already being arrested. They put out a warrant for these people's arrest, the police officers that were there. They didn't do anything. One guy just stand there and just looked at him. He didn't do anything. I think for some strange reason, I guess, they think that... not helping out the guy doesn't mean anything. You're not supposed to stand around and not help anybody. This guy was saying he couldn't breathe. The whole notion about he couldn't breathe means he hold his neck from... I'll show you where... If you have a neck of your own, you know what that means. On the ground, way down the ground. He couldn't breathe. That was sad in itself. To see those videos. I mean, everybody was saying their two cents on the video about what they saw and what they didn't see. Apparently it was 9 minutes of the video. I kid you not. 9 minutes of the video. This was inside the police vehicle and outside the police vehicle. Just right near the police vehicle, the guy was putting his foot on his neck. And everybody got off their camera, their little mobile device camera thing, and filmed it for social media assumption, and filmed it. And you can see it on the video that he couldn't breathe. He told everybody on the videos that he couldn't breathe. But now he passed away. When he was in police custody, as they would say, he died. He died in police custody. Yes, as sadly as that may seem, he did. And that's why we, thus we had the memorial service. They're playing gospel music. The music of choice is gospel music. That's the music genre they play in every funeral service. Not every funeral service around the world, they do play gospel music. But when it's needed, that's what we do. And when people pass away, we play gospel music. When their loved ones, doesn't matter who they are around the world, they play gospel music to soothe the soul, to soothe the people in the afterlife, to move to, to really, really make that, remember, you have to give someone 72 hours after they passed away to really, really give an EVP recording. An EVP recording means a lot of things. Anyway, folks, that's where you have it, folks. There you go. So that's all I have to say. Peace, y'all.